Hello everybody, hope all of you are well, and today I will continue this chapter, that is matter and its compositions. So before that, I will give you the answer of the previous day's assessment test, okay. So there was 5 MCQ. Your first question was, who named chemistry? Options are Robert Charles, Sir Robert Boyle, Mendeleev, Nobel. Okay, your answer will be the option 2, that is the Sir Robert Boyle. Your next question is, what is the total number of elements discovered? So your answer will be 118. Your next question was, which is not a matter? So your options were book, light, air and water. So your answer will be light. Light is an energy, not a matter. Which matter is not man-made? House, train, air, light. These are the options. So your answer will be air. Even we can prepare artificial light. Okay, sunlight is natural. But your answer will be air. Okay, air is not man-made, it's natural. And last MCQ was, which matter is non-living? Options are elephant, river, plant and bacteria. Your answer will be the river. Okay, so next I will start your second lesson of this chapter. So today I will start from composition and characteristics of matter. In ancient time, people thought that all kinds of matter are made up of air, water, earth, sky and fire, and it's called as panchatattva. Later, Maharshi Konark and Sir John Dalton proposed that all kinds of matters are made up of atoms. Actually, the whole universe is made up of matter and waves. Each matter, wave or particle. Sir Louis de Broglie proposed that all matter has properties of both waves and particles. Later, in higher classes, you will study about the idea of the wave-particle duality. Today in your syllabus, there is no scope of discussion, okay? Even light has both particle and wave nature. Now, if you take a piece of paper and tear it again and again into small pieces, then there is no change of properties of paper, but size of the paper decreases, and we conclude that paper is made up of very tiny particles which exhibits all the properties of paper. Paper is actually made of cellulose, okay? And cellulose is a polymer. Later you will understand what is polymer, and made of glucose, okay? Finally, by decreasing the size of the paper, we shall get the molecules of glucose by dissociation, and that will be made of what? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So finally we will get that atoms of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So an atom is the smallest possible unit of matter. We can define atom as the smallest particle of matter that may or may not exist independently, but can take part in a chemical reaction. Okay. Only the noble gas atom like helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, they can exist independently in their atomic state, because their octet is filled up, outermost valence electron is complete, so they generally do not form bond with other atoms, okay, or other elements. But other elements, other than these noble gases, they combine with each other and form molecules. Molecules can exist independently. Size of the molecules are bigger than compared to the atoms. A molecule can be formed of same atoms like oxygen molecule. Okay, here both the atoms are oxygen. Okay, and molecule may be made up of different atoms like water molecules. Here two different types of atoms are present, hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, now what is the definition of molecule? A molecule is the smallest unit of matter which exhibits all the properties of that kind of matter and has the capability to exist independently. So molecule can exist independently, but atom cannot exist independently. So molecules can be monoatomic, it may be diatomic, triatomic, tetraatomic, polyatomic. So noble gases are monoatomic, but hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, they are diatomic molecules. I can show you one oxygen molecule or hydrogen molecule. Suppose they have two oxygen atoms there. Between two oxygen atoms, there is double bond. Later you will understand. But if you think about these are two hydrogen atoms, okay, so this is the hydrogen molecule. They are joined by a bond, that is the attraction force, okay. And here this bond is continuous, the atoms are rotating, okay, like this. So this is oxygen molecule, okay. So this is a diatomic molecule. Both atoms are what? Oxygen atom, okay. And we can think about nitrogen atom also in the same way. Two nitrogen atom will be triply bonded, okay. And this is also a diatomic molecule. We can think about hydrogen molecule. This is also a diatomic molecule, okay. Now, a pure substance in which a molecule is made up of only one kind of atoms or atoms of the same kind, they are called element. And when atoms of different elements combine, okay, each other, then they are called compounds, like water, carbon dioxide, methane, ammonia. We can think about water molecule. This is the model of water molecule. This red ball is the, we are considering atom as a sphere. So this red ball is the oxygen atom. And these two are hydrogen atoms. So this hydrogen is attached, two hydrogens are attached with this oxygen atom by a single bond. Okay, so this is the model or structure, V-shaped structure of water molecule. So this is a what type of? This is a triatomic molecule. Okay, hope this is your compound. This is not the elemental molecule. Okay, here different types of atoms are present. But if we think about the methane molecule, this one is the methane molecule. You see this methane molecule, tetrahedral shape. Carbon is attached with the four hydrogen atom in four bond. Okay, here between carbon and hydrogen one single bond is present. Later you can understand when we discuss in higher classes. So this is the methane molecule. Okay, actually molecules are very small in size. You are not able to see the molecule because they are in maybe angstrom level. Okay, 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter. Okay. Or maybe molecules may be bigger size, they may be nanometer also, okay. They are not visible by your natural eyes, okay. So next I can show you another molecule, that is carbon dioxide molecule. In carbon dioxide molecule, carbon is attached with two oxygen atoms. So here this one is the carbon, yellow ball, and these two are oxygen. So this carbon dioxide molecule and its shape is the linear. And next I will show you the ammonia molecule. Okay, so this is the ammonia molecule. Nitrogen is attached with three hydrogen atom. Okay, so when we'll discuss the chapter of language of chemistry, then you can easily understand the formula and about their structures. Okay, about their structures. So these are all about the molecules. Okay, now I hope you can understand the difference between the atoms and molecule. Next we'll discuss the characteristics particles of matter. Particles of matter have space between them and it is called intermolecular space. Okay, so here if we think about this that oxygen molecule, so between two oxygen molecules there is some space. This space is called what? Intermolecular space. So if we dip a spoon inside water taken in a glass, so this is a glass containing water. If we dip a spoon inside this water, then what is happening? You observe. So the water level rises up. If we give a mark, then you can easily understand that water level is giving up because a spoon has some volume, so it occupies some space. Hope you can understand. Now if we add some salt or sugar, now we have NaCl, sodium chloride. So this is sodium chloride salt, this one is sodium chloride salt, okay. Now we are adding inside this water. And this sodium chloride dissociate into Na plus and Cl minus, and slowly it will become soluble in water. Now see, and here we observe that the level of water before and after addition is same. So why the level is not increasing here? So what is the cause behind it? Actually, the salt particle dissociates inside the water and dissolves. Okay, and it will take the space. Salt particles dissociate into ions, Na plus Cl minus ions, and the size of the Na plus Cl minus is so small that it will go inside the molecular space. Okay, or inside the space between the molecule, water molecules, and there is no increase in the water level, and this proves that the existence of the intermolecular space. So in your home also, whatever activity we are showing here, you can do. You take a glass, okay, and take some water, and if you have marker, just mark the level of water, then you add salt and check whether the water level increases or decreases or remains same. And in another case, if you take the glass half with water, and then if you add some stone or any solid materials, then what you will observe, whether the level is increasing or decreasing or remains same, that you observe, then you can easily understand. And today I also proved that the existence of the intermolecular space. Okay. Now, in case of gas, the intermolecular space is the highest, but in solid, the intermolecular space is the lowest. So they are tightly packed in case of solid. And in case of liquid, the intermolecular space is less than gas but higher than that of solid. So we know that matter generally have or exist three states: solid, liquid, gas. Later when discuss about the solid, liquid, gas, that the states of matter, then again you can understand, okay, properly. Next, we'll go to the second property of matter. Particles of matter are always in random motion. Okay. In the year 1827, Sir Robert Brown, Scottish botanist, okay, observed that the pollen grains were moving throughout the water in a zigzag motion through his microscope. Okay. And the cause of this motion of these pollen grains is that tiny water particles are in random motion and pollen grains experience some unbalanced force, and that is why they have some kinetic energy. Okay. And the motion is known as Brownian motion. Actually, this is because of the motion of the water molecule, okay? And water molecule is pushing that pollen grains, okay? And that is why it is moving in zigzag way. That means their path is not fixed, okay? So, if we take some water and add few drops of ink into it, then what you will observe, okay? Now, we'll do again one activity. So this is water taken in a glass, and here we'll add some blue ink. I will see what is happening. Now the blue ink is mixing inside the water molecule slowly, and it is forming a uniform mixture. Okay. So after some time when you observe, then you can easily understand. Okay, so if we take some ink and add inside water, what you will observe, the property is known as diffusion. The blue ink slowly diffuses and after some time we shall get a blue color solution. Okay, now you see almost blue, whole solution turns into blue color solution. Okay, now this is because of the random motion of water particles, and blue color ink particles spread uniformly in water and turning the whole water into a blue color solution. Now you see this solution, now it is a homogeneous mixture, okay, and turning into a blue color solution. So this experiment also you can do or perform in your home also, okay. Next, another experiment. So what it proves, observation is that the blue ink particle slowly diffuse inside the water uniformly and finally we will get a blue color solution, okay. And the, what is the inference of this experiment, that the particles of matters, okay, are always in random motion. Next, another experiment you can do or you will perform in your home. If you take a glass half filled with water and add some sawdust, okay, and if you just sprinkle over the surface, then what you will observe, if you can collect one magnifying glass, then through magnifying glass you will observe that the sawdust particles move randomly, okay, on the surface of the water. And why they are moving randomly? Again, because the random motion of the water molecule, okay. So actually these particles will get some kinetic energy, okay. Now if we have some arrangement of heating, so if we apply heat, then what will happen? If we increase the temperature, then the kinetic energy as well as the movement of the particle will increase. But if we decrease the temperature, again what will happen? The kinetic energy will decrease as well as the movement of the particle decreases. So in gas, particles have the highest kinetic energy. In liquid, particles have lower kinetic energy, okay, than the gas. But in solid particles, practically there is no kinetic energy of the particles, okay, solid particles or matters, okay. Actually, in solid particles or in solid matter, okay, the particles in the solid state have some special type of energy that is called vibrational. So this is called vibration, okay. So vibrational energy is special. Next, we will go to the another property of matter, that is the particles of matters attract each other. There is force of attraction between the particles of matter and is called interparticle force. This force holds the atoms and molecules together in a matter or substance. Okay, so next activity we can show you. So this is a chalk pencil, generally we are using in a blackboard. Now if we apply pressure, what will happen? If we apply pressure vertically, then we cannot break. But here, in this way, horizontally, if we give the pressure, then it will break easily. So we can break easily the chalk pencil. Okay. Now we are taking the spoon. Okay. And here also we are giving force, but it is not possible to break. We're trying huge amount of force we are giving, but it is not breaking. Now the question is, why we can easily break the chalk pencil but we cannot break the spoon made of steel, okay. So that you have to think. So definitely in case of chalk, the attraction among the particles are weak. That is why less force is required. But in case of the spoon, okay, the attraction is very high. And here we have to give very high force, okay, so that we can break this spoon. So from here we can easily understand that particles of matter attract each other, and the magnitude of the interparticle attraction forces varies from matter to matter. Okay, in case of gas, the attraction is very low. In case of liquid, the attraction is higher. But in case of solid, the in case of solid like this, the attraction among the particles, that is the interparticle attractions, are very high. So hope you can understand what I have discussed today. And again today I will give you one worksheet through Google form. You will try to solve, okay. And if you give the test, then I can give you the assignment marks. So today after this, thank you.